How do you know if error messages are negatively impacting the user experience? We define user-friendly error messages by how well they comply with our 12 error message guidelines. But guidelines tend to be broad, and they can be challenging to apply objectively to your particular situation. Let's explore how an error message scoring rubric can make these guidelines practical and easier to apply. A rubric is a reusable guide defining standard criteria to evaluate the quality of something. A rubric helps by getting colleagues involved in the process, making the analysis more consistent, and helping identify areas for improvement for your error message. Here's how to use the error message scoring rubric. First, download the rubric spreadsheet available in the article on our site. Next, select which error messages to review. Target frequently experienced ones, those within a critical workflow, or all of them for a comprehensive product audit. But don't analyze error messages in isolation. See how they present within the system by accessing a test environment or referencing video clips of them triggering. Then identify who will be doing the analysis. You or a team? Share and review the rubric with everyone before starting. Resolve any questions and make minor adjustments to the scoring criteria to help it fit your context. Let's take a look at the rubric and explain how to use it. The rubric has three dimensions that contribute to effective error messages: visibility, communication, and efficiency. We have other videos covering these dimensions in detail, so check them out if you want to learn more. Each dimension has four guidelines, and they all can be scored from excellent, 4 points, to poor, 1 point. The important section is the detailed scoring criteria for assigning a particular score. You can use a 0.5 decimal if the error message falls between two scores. And avoid sharing answers prematurely with others to reduce groupthink and bias. When finished, the spreadsheet will calculate the error message's overall letter grade. With multiple evaluators, average everyone's overall score to determine the error message's final grade. Earning an A means it's a top-tier user experience. Well done. Your team clearly understands the business value of helping users recover from errors. A B suggests there's some room for improvement. At least one category is probably scoring low and should be investigated. A C indicates that users' needs aren't really being prioritized. A low efficiency score could be the culprit here, since it takes more effort to score high than other categories. And a D means there are significant problems with the error message experience. Your team should review how it prioritizes, designs, and implements error messages before losing even more users to frustration. If you think error messages might be hurting the user experience, use this rubric to get your colleagues involved, make the analysis consistent and visible, and identify where improvements are needed. Show others that your UX analysis relies on objective standards and not just your personal opinions.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more of our UX videos, take a look at these over here and consider subscribing to our channel. On our website, nngroup.com, you can access our free library of over 2,000 articles. You can also register for one of our virtual UX conferences that offer live hands-on UX training.